You'll have to let us know how the volume is, because we're just, the room is super whoa, 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 whoa. I didn't notice there was a disco ball.
Yeah, for the second set.
I bought a car yesterday. First time in 17 years I bought a car. And the one I wanted I couldn't find anywhere, and then I found one in Everett. So I got up at 6 a.m. yesterday and drove to Everett. Bought a car, which is like getting a dental surgery. I drove back, and on the way up here today I was like, my God, I just drove here twice yesterday. Bones of the day broke away. Weary was left to say I should be done. Tried it. Where's Will Ferrell when you need him, man? played this gig outside of Seattle once. This place called Slim's Last Chance Saloon and Chili Shack. My career arc was like. And my wife and I stayed in this small town. Down state away, it's about 40 minutes out. And woke up in the morning and went to an antique store. I almost bought an accordion. I didn't. You're welcome. The song is about the three things I know absolutely nothing about. One is younger women, two is older women, and three is women of a certain age. This one's about a woman of a certain age who has a who spent some quality time with a young man who just came back from Vietnam. This is called In Her Prime.
Big old tree.
need like a note for where you're supposed to be, no one can write you on. This song takes place way back in 1989. It's farther away all the time. I was a senior in college at the time, and my roommate said, "Hey man, this weekend we should go drive down to Louisville and see this band called the Grateful Dead." So we did. Just a couple of wide-eyed college kids. It was the one time in the Grateful Dead's 50 or 60 year history now that they played a song by a band down in Portland where we live now. Band by the name of the Kings. That's right, the Grateful Dead played Louie Louie in Louisville, Kentucky. Now I just want you to think for just a second. Bear with me. Close your eyes. All right, close your eyes. And now I want you to think of the Kings been doing Louie Louie. You got it? All right, now open your eyes and think about the Grateful Dead doing Louie Louie. Like the single worst version of Louie Louie. Look it up on YouTube later tonight. After the show, we were headed down south, and wouldn't you know, we picked up this hitchhiker, follower of the Grateful Dead, a dead hand, he gave him a ride. This is the story of what happened that night. This is called Hank and Jesus. South of Louisville, Kentucky.
I said, you pull a little to the left. Jesus, keep on.
So, by the way, I have free What Would Hank and Jesus Do bumper stickers. One, they're free. Two, they're free. And three, like, inevitably, like, in this next election, your neighbor's gonna put a sticker on their car that's gonna just tick you off. So when it gets dark, we'll just walk over to his sticker and put my sticker on. I wrote the song one afternoon while listening to CNN in the background. And it won the 2019 Woody Guthrie Songwriting Award. That was pretty cool. It's called Ever Since Columbine.
how much the temperature in this place changes.
I just turned it down.
We got those nice heat lamps on us too. Forgot my sunscreen. I did this tour, I guess it was a spring tour, like a couple years ago now. I did 17 shows in 21 nights, and it was kind of brutal because everywhere I went, someone would say to me, you should have been here like 2 days ago, it was 70 degrees. And we're like, is that sleet or hail? And so everywhere we went, it snowed, it rained, it sleeted, it hailed, it whatever you could do. And then Storm Stella came up the coast. I was in Greensboro, North Carolina, and they were talking about snow, and I'm like, oh my God, I can't get out of this thing. And so I started joking around with the audience. I'm like, don't worry, like the sun will come out as soon as I leave, promise me. So then I wrote the song sort of in response to that. It's called The Sun's Gonna Shine When I'm Gone. Show like tomorrow. It was kind of mixed all the way up, but like, I discovered that God hates Shanelis. It's just, I don't know why, it's always raining through there. It could be 75 and sunny in the entire state, and you drive through that one little section, you're like, why is it cloudy and raining? It's also kind of a sing-along, so help us out.
But the law Thank you.
Oh,
Victor.
Yeah.
That's Luis. Brought to my attention in my household that I had not written a love song. It was also brought to my attention that all my other attempts at writing love songs were more like falling in lust songs. So I decided to write something that feels sort of like a love song. This one's called What You Gonna Do. I guess I'm not young anymore. That happened fast. Where's the door? Somebody show me where. Cause I need some air, I need a drink, I'd like a kiss, whatever you think.
All right, we're gonna. How you doing?
Paste them over political stickers.
You could do that.
side and how it just takes it over the stick. Like, I have so many, I just got a new guitar case, so I don't have any stickers in that one, but all my guitar cases are full of them, and all my friends give me stickers. So I didn't know what to do with all the stickers I was getting. Finally, one day I was in the basement, and I looked up at the ductwork in my shop, and I thought, there it is right there. And somebody moves into my house, they're going to be like, who was Bliss Hippie? Who is so-and-so? Political bumper stickers, just because I think they're fun. So both sides, like I'm not like. Every so often, I look up and I see Biden 08 up there, and I think, yeah. A little dusty. We're gonna do one more song here, and then take a break. I do have CDs for sale. They're one for 15, two for 20, or whatever the heck. You know, it's all good. We can take credit cards. I'm the number one seller of Dan Weber music, so catch up there. Did I mention I bought a car yesterday? The guy tried to sell me the extended warranty, and I was like, God, I don't think so. Joe, he was really nice. He had every bit of Seahawk stuff you could possibly have inside of his office. But I just couldn't bring myself to buy it where it was. I mean, lifetime oil change. Sounds cool, but I live 3.5 hours away, man. Yeah, right, I'll need another one. So, we're gonna do this one, let's take a break. And is anybody a fan of Woody Guthrie out there at all? I got to play the Woody Guthrie Book Festival now 4 times, and I won the contest last year, which is cool. I've gotten to meet Arlo a couple times. I got to meet Mary Jo, Woody's younger sister, before she passed a couple years ago. And Mary Jo, she's the host of Pancake Breakfast every Saturday morning. And I did my set, and I was backstage, and Mary Jo was back there, and she was telling stories about Oklahoma, and there was a bunch of us having breakfast. And then at some point, I realized there was nobody else there but just me and her. And she had moved on to lunch at this point, so we've been a while. She stops and looks at me and goes, Dan, I don't mean to be rude, but would you like a bite of my grilled cheese sandwich? You know, and she's like this tall, and she's wearing like a peach-colored, like rayon, sort of Jackie O era dress with a little pillbox hat on, like cute as a Bugsy. I was raised Catholic, and I was a park ranger and an Eagle Scout, and so I feel like I was raised right, at least my mother contends I was. And so I said, no, ma'am, thank you. And I spent like the next 14 and a half minutes thinking, is Woody Guthrie's DNA possibly on that sandwich somehow? And should I have taken a bite? What if she doesn't eat it all? Will I grab some? I never did get a bite of it, so maybe I missed out. This was called Old Woody in his honor for his 100th birthday. And it's a sing-along, and then we'll take a little break and come back and play some more tunes. Thanks.
Sure, you should.